Blessed be the one holy and living God.
Glory to God forever and ever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, you declare your almighty power chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Grant us the fullness of your grace, that we, running to obtain your promises, may be partakers of your heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me. What do you mean by repeating this proverb concerning the land of Israel? The parents have eaten sour grapes, and the children's teeth are set on edge? As I live, says the Lord God, this proverb shall no more be used by you in Israel. Know that all lives are mine, the life of the parent, as well as the life of the child is mine. It is only the person who sins that shall die. Yet you say, the way of the Lord is unfair. Hear now, O house of Israel. Is my way unfair? Is it not your ways that are unfair? When the righteous turn away from their righteousness and commit iniquity, they shall die for it. For the iniquity that they have committed, they shall die. Again, when the wicked turn away from the wickedness they have committed and do what is lawful and right, they shall save their life. Because they considered and turned away from all the transgressions that they had committed, they shall surely live, they shall not die. Yet the house of Israel says, the way of the Lord is unfair. O house of Israel, are my ways unfair? Is it not your ways that are unfair? Therefore, I will judge you, O house of Israel, all of you according to your ways, says the Lord God. Repent and turn from all your transgressions. Otherwise, iniquity will be your ruin. Cast away from you all the transgressions that you have committed against me, and get yourselves a new heart and a new spirit. Why will you die, O house of Israel? For I have no pleasure in the death of anyone, says the Lord God. Turn then and live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. My God, I put my trust in you.
Let me not be humiliated, nor let my enemies triumph over me.
Let none who look to you be put to shame.
Let the treacherous be disappointed in their schemes.
Show me your ways, O Lord.
And teach me your paths.
Lead me in your truth and teach me.
For you are the God of my salvation. In you I have trusted all the day long.
Remember, O Lord, your compassion and your love.
For they are from everlasting.
Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions.
Remember me according to your love and for the sake of your goodness, O Lord.
Gracious and upright is the Lord.
Therefore, he teaches sinners in his way.
He guides the humble in doing right.
And teaches his way to the lowly.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus entered the temple, and the chief priests and elders of the nation came to him with the question, "By what authority are you acting like this? Who gave you this authority?" Jesus replied, "I have a question to ask too. Answer it, and I will tell you by what authority I act. The baptism of John, was it from God or from men?" This set them arguing among themselves. "If we say from God, he will say, then why did you not believe him? But if we say from men, we are afraid of the people, for they all take John to be a prophet." So they answered, "We do not know." And Jesus said, "Then neither will I tell you by what authority I act. But what do you think about this? A man had two sons. He went to the first and said, 'My boy, go and work today in the vineyard.' 'I will, sir,' the boy replied, but he never went. The father came to the second son and said the same. 'I will not,' he replied, but afterwards he changed his mind and went. Which of these two did as the father wished?" "The second," they said. Then Jesus answered, "I tell you this, tax gatherers and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God ahead of you. For when John came to show you the right way to live, you did not believe him. But the tax gatherers and prostitutes did. And even when you had seen that, you did not change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Good morning and welcome. For many years, it has been the tradition of the Cathedral of St. John the Divine to observe at a Sunday service the annual beginning of the General Assembly of the United Nations and to invite the President of the General Assembly to address us here at the Cathedral. We are proud to do so once again. Today, we are honored to welcome His Excellency Volkan Bozkir, who has been elected president of the General Assembly for this, the 75th annual session. Following graduation from law school, he joined the Turkish Foreign Service and has served both at home and abroad. Over his 39 years of service to Turkey, he has served in various roles, 9 years as an elected member of the parliament, and then the diplomatic corps. His experience in foreign service includes first secretary to the embassy in Baghdad, consul general in New York City, ambassador in Bucharest, permanent representative of Turkey to the European Union. He also served as chief foreign policy advisor to two presidents of Turkey. Now, as the 75th General Assembly of the United Nations begins its work, he has been elected president to lead in taking up matters of global importance. President Bozkurt's priority in this session of the General Assembly is to address the matters of multinationalism and strengthening nations and cooperating to reach shared goals. The General Assembly will also address climate change and its effects. This coming Saturday is the International Day of Calling for the Elimination of Nuclear Weapons. The United Nations' primary goal is to seek peace, unity, and cooperation among nations, and the extending of human rights and respecting the dignity of every person. In this difficult endeavor, setbacks and disappointments are real, though ultimately transitory. The eternal reality that will prevail is hope and faith in God's love of peace for the prospering of creation and the well-being of all people. The universe is bent by its designer in that direction. Your Excellency, it is an honor and a pleasure to welcome you to address the people of the Cathedral of St. John the Divine and the city of New York.
His Excellency Antonio Guterres, Secretary General, Right Reverend Clifton Daniel III, Excellencies, fellow citizens of the world, I thank you for inviting me to this special occasion. This event is a reminder that the United Nations has something in common with all places of worship. Our doors are always open. Even when physical meetings were not possible, both the UN headquarters and religious institutions sought out virtual means of connecting with our community. We saw this at the highest level of intergovernmental affairs at the general debate. The virtual nature of these engagements can broaden our reach. Technology is bringing us closer to the communities we serve. This is critical. Community made social distancing bearable. Many leaned on their faith to guide them through the darkest days of the pandemic. I extend my deepest sympathies to those who have lost loved ones in this period, to those who are suffering from the effects of COVID-19. Know that you are not alone. We are and will remain in this together. Spiritual leaders and the United Nations family are both driven by a calling to act in the best interests of the people we serve. In 2015, the world pledged to leave no one behind. Trust me, we have not forgotten. In the 75th year of the United Nations, I invite you to pause for reflection. How can we improve our work? I firmly believe that we must amplify the voices of the most vulnerable. Throughout my tenure as the President of the General Assembly, I will endeavor to support the humanitarian agenda of the United Nations and strengthen the coordination of humanitarian and disaster relief assistance to those in need, with a focus on the most vulnerable. In this decade of action and delivery, we must now move to make gains on the 2030 agenda. We must bridge the digital divide. We must rebuild sustainably. We must each uphold our individual responsibility for achieving gender equality. Our diversity is our strength, and by listening to a multitude of perspectives, we will improve our response to the world's problems. 75 years ago, The United Nations was established as a center for harmonizing the actions of nations. We must recommit to this ideal. I urge you to draw strength from those who have gone before us, the penholders of the Charter of the United Nations, dared to dream of a better world at a time of pervading distrust. Let us move forward together with hope. Better days lie ahead. Thank you.
Thank you.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, hear our prayer. We join our sisters and brothers throughout the Anglican Communion in praying this day for the Episcopal Church of Sudan. With all the Episcopalians in the Diocese of New York, remember Christ Church and San Marcos in Tarrytown, where a bishop was to have made his visitation today. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the world's Jewish people as this evening they begin the observance of Yom Kippur. Even as God's chosen people mourn their sins and atone for the wrongs they have done, let us pray that the world will never forget the wrongs that have been done to the Jews. Especially, let us pray that denials of the Holocaust will be overcome by the proclamation of truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for populations and places seeing an increase in coronavirus infections, and for the scientists and physicians who are working to protect and serve. We continue to pray for Anthony Fauci with thanksgiving. This week, we are mindful of Deborah Birx. We pray that science will triumph over politics. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for students and teachers and school administrators as they seek safe and successful ways to move ahead. We are mindful of our own cathedral school and the head of school, Marsha Nelson, and New York City's other Episcopal schools and all the other schools in our great city. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our western states where the forest fires still burn. Let us pray for all those whose lives and livelihoods and property are being destroyed. Let us pray for the firefighters. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the city of Louisville and all the people there who march in protest. Let us pray for an end to racial strife and racial violence. Let us pray for all who mourn Breonna Taylor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us pray for the electorate. Let us pray for the safety and integrity of our electoral process. Let us pray for the survival of our democracy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us be mindful of those sick and suffering in any trouble or any need. We have been asked this week to pray for Liz Milvey, for David, for Dan Bergfeld and Phil Hughes, for Danuta Whitlow, Patricia Cortez, Linda and Rick, for Marsha Raw, for Harry Johnson and Leslie Johnson, for Sheila Thompson and Kate. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For whom else, ill or in any kind of distress, should we pray today? Let us name them aloud or hold them in mind and heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us give thanks for life's blessings, remembering especially those whose generosity sustains the cathedral through our response and recovery fund. For what else should we give thanks this day? Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the rest and resurrection of the dead, especially Gary Cowlin, Jillian Eversole Survey, and Nancy True, who have been recommended to our prayer this week. And let us now commend to God's care others who have died. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear the prayers of your people and what we have asked faithfully, grant that we may obtain effectually to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And now, as our Saviour has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
The mercy, grace, and peace of God Almighty, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you this day and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.